Hola, buenos dias, good morning, my beautiful people. Welcome back to the channel. It's your girl here, Daniela, Miss Four Lizard, the planning diva. And I'm here with my fitness planner. I'm obsessed with this case here. In my last fitness plan with me, I showed you all that I've been transitioning into keeping all of my fitness and meal planning stuff in this gorgeous Happy Planner packaging tote situation thing. I've been just really inspired by this tote and using it to just keep all of my planners, my fitness stuff, because I always have like so many planner stickers, and I've just been really inspired by it because I have my fitness planner stuff everywhere and it's kind of hard to like get it all out and put it all back. And so I've just been really inspired by just like putting everything in that tote and just having everything in one place. So I have all of my fitness sticker books here, mild liners, gel pens, you name it, I have it. But I actually just finished filming that last plan with me like an hour ago, and then I took my dogs for a walk, and now I'm gonna film another fitness plan with me because I'm not gonna be here next weekend. And so I just wanna get it all set up so that way when I come back next weekend, it's, you know, good to go and I don't have to spend any time thinking about setting it up. I can just dive right into it. So I'm gonna be setting up my fitness program for the 21st through the 27th of the month. So if you're interested in seeing what I get into, then just keep on watching. But before I get into it, I just quickly want to say that I don't know if y'all noticed, but when I set up this plan with me, I completely messed up and I actually set it up for the week that I had missed. So for the month of November, let me pull this out here. First of all, I am using this super cute color block Mickey divider. It's adorable. And I started setting up my monthly workout overview. I like using the monthly to keep track of all my workouts and just to get a bird's eye perspective of what I'm doing in a month's time. And this week, the week of Halloween, I actually set everything up but didn't do anything because my sister was visiting this week. She came in on the 1st and I was just so busy like being with her and hosting and just, you know, trying to be in the moment. So I actually didn't get to, you know, plan in this at all. And then the following week, November the 7th through the 13th, I actually didn't, I wasn't in my planner at all. So I had a blank spread. And then when I started setting up my spread for the 14th through the 20th, I totally did it on that blank week. And so what I ended up doing was whiting out the dates and then just using stamps to stamp out the dates there at the top. So it's going from the 6th to the 14th. And then I just took out a page, redated the back of this one, and now we're good to go. So I'm just missing one week in here, but that's totally fine. I totally did not realize until I was absolutely done with the spread. I cannot believe I didn't realize, but let's just get into the plan with me. I do like a very formulaic plan with me because I don't really want to think about it too much. I just wanna, you know, set it up on paper and then go from there. This isn't a planner in which I'm trying to be decorative. It's just a planner that I use to keep track of all of my workouts and just to, you know, motivate me to work out. So I'm not really trying to be creative or decorative or cute in this planner. So I just follow this really basic formula, and for me it's entertaining. You know, the fact that I'm just even journaling or using stickers, that's enough for me. But I like using one of these like longer stickers. It's a week at a glance sticker for exercise. And I just like using it to pre-plan my workouts. And I think it'll be fun to use these three neon jelly rolls. So I think I'm gonna use these. And in terms of exercise, very similar to how I pre-planned last week. We're gonna step it up. So I'm gonna kind of look at what I did last week and then just take it up one notch, just a tiny little notch. but the goal is to continuously ramp it up until I'm just like a beast. So Monday last week, I did a 1.5 mile run. Let's amp it up. Let's do a 2 mile run. I think I'm ready for it. I used to run like 10 miles at a time last year, 2 years ago, and I just kind of fell away from that. So we're gonna slowly ramp it up. Okay, Tuesday, run plus abs. So I'm gonna do run plus abs again, and I'll just amp it up from last week. Wednesday, I did a booty and walk. I'm gonna do a run plus a walk, but I might only do like a mile and a half. Thursday, I did run and arms, so I'm gonna do run plus arms again. And then Friday, run plus stretch, run plus full body. Let's get into it. Saturday, stretch plus legs. Saturday, stretch plus walk. And then Sunday, I'm gonna do a full body. Oof, let's see how that goes. Okay, and then just like last week, I'm just gonna do some decoration in this corner. It's like my little corner where I can, you know, have some fun. I just got this Agenda 52 sticker book and it's beautiful. So let me see what we have here. I might grab like this cute little like workout gear sticker if it wants to peel off the page. So I'll just lay this down here. It looks like we're going for a green theme. I did not plan it like that. It's just what's happening. So little workout sticker there. And then I think I'm gonna get the get up and go sticker and just lay it right there. And maybe even these little weights. I'll drop these weights right there. And I think that's it. Maybe a little hydrating bottle sticker just here at the side. Yeah, that's really cute. Okay, and then hydration trackers. We're gonna put some hydration trackers down there in the bottom. I have a very, very formulaic fitness plan with me style, technique. I do pre-plan, decoration, hydration trackers, strength workouts, plus any other workouts that didn't fit up in here, Fitbit stats in this row, and then I have movement up here. And my movement is like stretching, running, walking, kind of like the bare minimum that I hope to, you know, accomplish in a day. And then the grid section is like if I'm going above and beyond what, you know, I tend to do, and adding in an additional workout or if I'm doing a strength workout. Because for me, I'm always walking at the very least because I have dogs and I have to walk them. So I always have some movement going on. I always have like walking up here, and I do tend to run. It's probably one of my favorite workouts. So a lot of the times I will, you know, run as my first workout of choice. And if I, you know, do an additional workout on top of running, if it's like a strength workout, that will go down here. So that's kind of how I set up my fitness plan with me. And I just ran out of hydration trackers, unfortunately. So I think what I'm gonna have to do is make my own. Wait, let me check if I have any hydration trackers in here. I feel like this book would have some hydration trackers. Workout tracker, okay. Let's see. Oh, here we go, Hydrate Girl. So let's do this. Let's put one here. They're not as cute as the water bottle ones with the little water drops, but they'll do. They'll do. So I'll just put another one here, and then last. Oh, I kind of don't want to like double up with the colors. So let's go for this deep blue one. There we go. And it kind of opens up some space right here. I'm usually not used to having space down there. So I'm thinking of potentially just adding some washi down there, because why not, right? I think that would be fun. Let's see. I kind of want to add like some blue washi or some green washi. Let's see. What should I use? Okay, how about this washi? This is a Sumiko Garashi washi. It's a kawaii Japanese character. And I think I just got this at Daiso. So I think it'd be fun to just add like a little strip here. Ah! Did you see that? And I feel like I could add a little accent washi right underneath there. This really thin washi. I'm trying to use my washi. I'm trying to get through as much washi as possible. So, you know, I'm just gonna add washi as much as I can. All right, and then I'm just gonna go ahead and do my Fitbit stats here. I like keeping track of my steps most of all. That's the main one. And then miles, calories, floors, and sleep. So I'm gonna go ahead and write that out in these boxes and then use mildliners to map out where I'm actually gonna write those stats, kind of like how I did here. So let's go ahead and do that. And there we go, a really simple Fitbit stat tracker. And I just went with these mild liners in blues and greens because it looks like blue and green is the theme this week. Again, I don't really use my fitness planner decoratively. I don't really care to make it very decorative. And I also tend to not have a lot of space in here to be decorative. So I try to, you know, be creative and be decorative and be fun in little ways, like, you know, using like mildliners to do like a rainbow for the Fitbit tracker and just kind of like sticking to a monochromatic color palette. I find that's a really simple way to just keep it fun, but still functional. Okay, now I'm gonna set up each day's workouts. So similarly to how I did the run stats workouts up here, I think what I'm gonna do is set up a similar tracker. So actually let me put that sticker down. I'm gonna set up run stats trackers on the days that I'm running, which are going to be Monday through Friday. And I think I'm gonna use these Go For A Run stickers for the days that I am running. They're not all blue and green, but that's totally fine. So Go For A Run. Let's do it. It's gonna be Monday through Friday. Okay, I ended up not writing the words distance, pace, time, and calories for each one because I did that for this spread and I like how it looks, but it takes too much time. I don't know, and I don't really need to like write it so many times. That's why I need to make stickers, because I want a sticker that gives me like run stats. And I just would love that, and I don't know, I don't want to like order them from someone because I would just spend way too much money when I can just do it myself. So definitely gonna be releasing some run stats stickers with the small sticker business that I'm trying to get started with my friend. Okay, and I kind of want to use these cardio stickers with the shoes. So I'm gonna grab a couple of these and just pop them in for all of the days that I'm running, which are gonna be Monday through Friday. So a lot of cardio. I'm trying to get to the point where I'm running almost every single day, maybe, you know, taking one or two days off every, you know, 1 or 2 weeks. I want to eventually run a marathon. Like, that is the goal, that's the dream, and I just want to get into shape for it. And I think just developing the habit of like constantly running is gonna be the way, you know, to achieve that dream. And it's totally possible as long as you start, you know, slow, you maintain yourself, you take care of your body, you stretch, you know, you get massaged. It is totally possible to run, you know, fairly long distances every single day. I'm gonna start small. I'm gonna start off with like 1 mile, 2 miles a day, and then I'm slowly gonna pick that up. marathon runners run like 6, 7, 8 miles daily, you know, and getting ready for a race. And so I think that's so inspiring. Okay, Monday. The only thing I'm doing is running Monday. Tuesday, running and abs. So let me grab a box for abs right here. And then Wednesday is gonna be running and walking. So, okay, so in the case in which I have two movement workouts and movement goes up in this top row, and I can only fit one, I tend to just put the spillover movement workouts down here. So that's gonna be my walking box. And then Thursday I'm doing arms. So let me grab this sticker box right here and pop that down. I'll put it down here. And then Friday, full body workout. So let's see, let's grab the box. I wonder if I have any. Yeah, let's grab this one. So full body workout right here. And then Saturday is stretch and walk. So I have a walk up here, and what I might do is actually I just realized I have more hydration tracker stickers here. Oh well, I'll use those next week. Okay, Saturday is stretch and walk, so I'm going to do a stretch up here, and then this box will be my walk box. I'll put that right there. And Sunday, it's gonna be a full body workout. So let me see if I can find another box. Okay, yeah, I can use this today's workout sticker. And this is gonna be the full body workout. I'll put that up there. And I can grab this gold foil go for a walk sticker and put it right on top of the walking workout. I'm gonna grab this arm day sticker and put it on top of the Thursday arm workout. So let's put this right there. And some fun decorative stickers. I'll add this one right here, sweat, smile, and repeat. I'm just looking for, you know, blue, green type stickers. Ooh, I kinda like this one. Get sleep, eat clean, drink water, exercise, repeat. Let's put that one down there. And it would be fun to grab this sweat now, shine later sticker. There we go. And I'm gonna grab this, the only bad workout is the one that didn't happen sticker. And I'll pop that right here. Perfect. Really like how the spread is turning out. I think I'm gonna use my bright neon pink jelly rule to write out the workouts that I'm going to do, starting with Tuesday's ab workout. So last week I did a 15 minute ab total core workout, and I think I'm going to do a similar workout. I'm gonna, you know, up some of the workouts, but not all of the workouts, because I wanna, you know, increase my total, my complete exercise regimen incrementally. And if I incrementally increase the, you know, intensity level of every single workout, then that leads to a total, you know, pretty not unsubstantial workout increase. And so I'm going to up the ante on some of the days, but not all of them. So I'm going to repeat the 15 minute abs total core workout. For Wednesday, I'm going to walk. So actually, let me grab a walk sticker from this sticker book here. I can grab one of these nice gold foil ones and put this right on top of the walk. Thursday, it's gonna be an arm workout. And last week I did a 20 minute full upper body workout, and I think I am going to do a similar workout. So 20 minute full upper body workout. And then Friday, I'm going to do a run and a full body workout. So I'm going to do the same 20 minute full body workout for stress relief and flexibility, but that's not going to fit, so I'll just leave it like that. And then Saturday, it's going to be a stretch and a walk. I'm going to do the 15 minute front split stretch and then a walk, and I'm going to do a 1 hour walk on Saturday. And then on Wednesday, I'm going to do, I think, just my regular 30 minute walk. I mean, that kind of goes without saying because I walk my dogs every day for 30 minutes. I try to. Sometimes I don't walk them, but most of the days I do try to walk them at least 30 minutes. And then Sunday, it's going to be a full body, and I'm actually going to go all out with the full body. I'm going to do a 45 minute full body workout. So let's see how that goes. I'll put this workout log sticker here. And this is gonna be my full body workout, 45 minutes. I'll probably do like a Sydney Cummings workout, or maybe I'll do like two MadFit full body workouts, like a 20 minute and a 25 minute. And let's see how many calories I burn. Oh, and that also reminds me, I need to map out when I'm going to the gym. So, okay, I usually go to work Monday, Wednesday, Friday, but I think this week, because I'm not gonna be in town until Monday night, I think I might go to campus, go to work Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, and then I'll go to the gym Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday. So I'm gonna put my little gym sticker here, and then I'll also put it here, and then on a Friday as well. And I think that's it. I think that's my workout regimen for the 21st through the 27th. I really like how this spread came out. I'm feeling very like motivated when it comes to working out. And I even ran a little bit today, just a little bit, just a tiny little bit. I don't even like count it. It was like a full-on run. I was walking my dogs and then we ran for a few minutes. But I just kind of got in the mood to run, and I'm feeling motivated. So thank you so much for spending some time with me here today. I hope your workout programs go fantastically this week. Let me know how you're doing in the comments down below, and I hope to see you in my next video. So until then, stay safe, stay blessed, and happy planning. Bye.